الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم ما بعد. Sometimes we are without water when we want to purify ourselves, when we want to perform the ablution for prayer. So what should one do? When one is in the situation when they do not have water or they do not have enough water, then it is legislated and permissible in Islam for them to use dry earth, the tayammum. And let's look at the Quran, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Ma'idah. Qala tabaraka wa ta'ala fi kitabihi al-kareem, وَإِن كُنْتُمْ جُنُبٍ فَطَاهِرُوا وَإِن كُنْتُمْ مَرْضَى أَوْ عَلَى سَافِرٍ أَوْ جَاءَ أَحَدُكُمْ مِنْكُمْ مِنَ الْغَائِطِ أَوْ لَمَسْتُمُ النِّسَاءَ فَلَمْ تَجِدُوا مَاءً فَتَيَمَّمُوا صَعِيدًا طَيِّبًا فَامْسَحُوا بِوُجُوهِكُمْ وَأَيْدِيكُمْ مِنْهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, but if you are ill or on a journey, or any of you comes from relieving oneself, or you have been in contact with women, meaning you have had sexual relations, and you find no water, sexual intercourse more specifically, and you find no water, then perform tayammum and clean earth, and wipe therewith your faces and hands. And so in that verse it tells us some of the situations in which it is legislated for us to make tayammum, you know, to make the dry ablution with dry earth, clean earth. And also it mentions the body parts, that we should wipe what? You should wipe your faces and your hands. And let's listen to a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which gives us a little bit of background about the tayammum, about the dry ablution. It is reported on the authority of Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that she said, we set out with the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam on one of his journeys till we reach Al-Bayda or Zat al-Jash, where a necklace of mine was broken and lost. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam stayed there to search for it, and so did the people along with him. There was no water at that place, so the people went to Abu Bakr as-Siddiq and said, don't you see what Aisha has done? She has made the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the people stay where there is no water, and they have no water with them. Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu came while the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sleeping with his head on my thigh. So this is mentioning what Aisha, she's mentioning what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sleeping on her thigh. And he said to me, Abu Bakr said to Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anhu, you have detained the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the people that are with him, and there is no water, and they have no water with them. So he admonished me and said what Allah wished him to say, and he hit me on my flank with his hand. Nothing prevented me from moving because of pain but the position of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam in my thigh. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam got up when dawn broke and there was no water. So Allah revealed the divine verses of tayammum, and they all performed tayammum. Usayd ibn al-Hadr said, O family of Abu Bakr, this is not the first blessing of yours. Then the camel on which I was riding was caused to move from its place, and the necklace was found beneath it. And this was collected in, this is authentic hadith from Bukhari and Muslim. So that gives us a little bit of background about the tayammum, about the dry ablution, and the times when it is legislated according to the ayat that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed in accordance with that situation. And it's very important for us to learn those times on how those times when it's legislated to make tayammum. So that way we are able to deal with those situations. Maybe you're in your travels and you have run out of water and you have no access to water. And this is very common in traveling, especially when you travel in many third world countries and so forth, where water may be scarce, and especially in many of the Arab countries. And you'll find the applicability of this, that it's very applicable. And you also may find yourself out hiking or doing other activities when you need water, and you have no access to water. So this gives us a little bit of background about tayammum and how we should deal with those situations. And we will also talk about, mention some other hadith narrations and about the actual conditions for tayammum and so forth. And I ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Anything I said that was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything I said that was incorrect was from myself and the shaytan. Wa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam.